What are the symptoms of cervical radiculopathy, and how do you know which nerve in your neck is causing your symptom of cervical radiculopathy? In this video, with the use of spine models and nerve charts, I will show you the nerve distributions of the nerves of the cervical spine, which parts of the arms and hands and fingers are related. Like this, you have an idea of which potential nerve in your neck can be causing the symptoms associated with radiculopathy that you may be experiencing. So what is cervical radiculopathy? It essentially is symptoms in the arms, forearm, hands, and fingers, like numbness, tingling, or pain, even weakness possibly, that is sourced or related to the origin in the neck region. We'll talk a bit more about that in a moment. But anyone that is suffering with symptoms related to cervical radiculopathy realizes how worrisome they are, not knowing how to correct it possibly, or how long it will be there for, and can actually affect their daily activity. Some of the things they may be experiencing is trouble sleeping at night because of that arm numbness, tingling, or arm pain, or losing grip strength and dropping like a coffee mug or some other items, or just heaviness in the arm and pain shooting down into the arms, hands, and fingers. Those are some of the more typical symptoms associated with radiculopathy. So if you have cervical radiculopathy, how do you know which areas of the spine or which spinal nerves are associated with your symptoms? So in this video, I'm going to talk more about that and show you where these nerves distribute and the patterns along the arm, forearm, and hands and fingers, and which nerves are associated with that in the neck. Hey there, I'm Dr. Walter Salubro. I'm a corrective care chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. And what this channel is about is giving you tips and strategies on how to strengthen and stabilize your back, and even introduce you to corrective chiropractic technique, non-surgical corrective methods. Like this, you can learn about how to correct your spinal problem and also begin to live your life and bend, move, and lift easier and normally without pain limitation. So if you want these tips and strategies, be sure to subscribe right now, tap the notification bell, like this you don't miss out on my weekly videos. So let's take a look at this spine model right here. So here's an actual spine model, and I labeled the cervical area. So the cervical spine has seven vertebrae, okay? So C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7. And this is looking at the spine from the front view, okay? In between are the discs, so the white blocks of the vertebra. These jelly objects here are the discs, and then these yellow strands over here are the nerves. So in the cervical spine, even though there's seven vertebrae, there are actually 8 cervical nerve roots. So there's C1 that comes out the top, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, and C8. So cervical radiculopathy, the symptoms can arise from irritation of these nerves when they open, where these openings are over here. And that irritation can be caused by spinal degenerative changes like spinal arthritis, can be caused by disc disease, degenerative disc disease, protruding into there, so a disc bulge, disc herniation, a combination of that, and even abnormal alignment that's stretching those nerves and the actual tension of the spinal cord on the backside. So those are some of the common things that could accumulate over time and irritate those nerves that lead to those cervical radicular symptoms into the arm. So let me show you on this nerve chart here how these nerves come from the neck into the brachial plexus into the arms, and then eventually I'll show you a dermatome chart that shows the exact distribution of these nerves. So you'll know what a C5, C6 radiculopathy will go to, where a C6, C7 radiculopathy goes to based on this dermatome chart. So let's go to this chart right here. You've seen this chart before in my other videos. It's a spinal nerve chart. Let's look at it from the back side. So if we look at the neck over here, here's the cervical spine. These are the cervical nerve roots, just like I showed you in the spine model over here. So see, the nerves that go into the actual arms over here will be C5, C6, C7, C8, and then part of the upper thoracic spine, that nerve root, which is T1. They make up the brachial plexus. Brachial means arm. So brachial plexus. Plexus means a bundle of nerves. So this area here is called the brachial plexus in the shoulder girdle area. And then the brachial plexus will branch off into these different nerves, like the medial nerve, the ulnar nerve, the radial nerve, and these nerves form into the arm and eventually branch out into smaller nerves, okay? So that's where the nerve distribution originates from the neck into the shoulders, arms, hands, and fingers. So some nerves will go to the lateral part of the arm over here. So outside is over here, the lateral part, in an anatomical position. Some nerves will go to the middle part of the hand over here, and some nerves will go to the inner part, the medial aspect of the arm, okay? So there are 3 main branches of nerves in the actual arm, and I'll break them down for you. There's the median nerve, which is made up of C5, C6, C7, C8, T1 nerve root. And the median nerve goes down the center of the arm, okay, into the middle fingers and also the index finger. Then there's the radial nerve. The radial nerve is made up of C5, C6, C7, C8, T1 also. And this nerve distribution goes mostly to the lateral forearm and also into the thumb. And then there's the ulnar nerve. Ulnar nerve is made up of C7, C8, T1 nerve. And this nerve distribution goes into the medial inner part of the forearm, into the pinky finger, the fifth finger. So follow the dermatome chart over here that you see just above me here. And I'll go over some of the symptoms associated with radiculopathy at each of the levels in the neck region. So when there is a C5 radiculopathy, the disc area that's involved that could be contributed to that would be the C4, C5 disc. So C4, C5 disc or the C4, C5 level, if there's arthritic changes, will contribute a C5 radiculopathy, which would be mostly problems with the shoulder region, okay? Maybe weakness in the shoulder area, okay? And upper arm area, and also around the shoulder blade area, because that's where that C5 nerve goes to. A C6 radiculopathy, that would be the area of the C5, C6 disc. So C5, C6 disc bulge can contribute to a C6 radiculopathy, also degeneration at the openings of the C5, C6 level, and that will cause things like a weakness along the neck and arm, and including the bicep area into the wrist. But predominantly the C6 area would be that thumb index region, okay, mostly the thumb, okay. And then there's C7 radiculopathy, is the C6 C7 disc area. So if there's a C6 C7 disc bulge, it's one of the most common areas of radiculopathy, that will cause a C7 radiculopathy, and that's going to be really pain, weakness, into the tricep areas, and also into the middle finger, okay? And associated with all these symptoms can be also numbness and tingling. And then there's C8 radiculopathy. So C8 radiculopathy would be the C7 T1 disc area. If there's a disc bulge here, can contribute to C8 radiculopathy, or even degeneration at the C7 T1 area. And that will actually be obviously pain in the neck and also along the arm, but along the inside of the arm into the pinky finger, okay? So if I had to break it down into the three main areas, it would be a C6 radiculopathy distribution into the thumb and lateral forearm by a C5, C6 disc bulge or degeneration in that area. C7 radiculopathy, which would be the middle finger, okay, by a C6, C7 disc bulge or degeneration of the area. And then a C8 distribution in the pinky finger, which would be C7, T1 disc bulge degeneration of that area. So now you know the actual dermatome and the nerve distributions into the arms and fingers. You know that cervical radiculopathy can cause weakness, pain, numbness, tingling into these areas, especially numbness and tingling. You're wondering, what can you do about it? Well, you should get your spine checked by a corrective care chiropractor, get some spinal x-rays done, and see what kind of corrections that are required to correct the underlying spinal conditions that are leading to disc damage, degeneration, and nerve irritation. And if you're looking for some home exercises, I have a great video on nerve flossing for radicular symptoms or cervical radiculopathy. Go check this video right over here for some great nerve flossing, nerve glide exercises for cervical radiculopathy.